There are tons of criticisms coming to my channel in regards to content. A lot of people have told me that I did nothing but very low-hanging fruits and that I should give a lot more hot takes. Well, I don't really have any sorts of controversial opinion towards something, except if you ask my opinions on probably certain video games or movies, but that's about it. But I did low-hanging fruits because they are entertaining. They are good materials to mock, and people find them funny as well. Which brings me to the second criticism that I got all the time, in that I always mock people instead of going to their points and discuss actual criticisms that people have towards certain issues. To suggest that I am mocking people all the time is ridiculous. While I do mock people at many times, I don't mock them all the time. A lot of times I try to propose solutions or ask for certain evidences or highlight inaccuracies in their premise. Sometimes I even want to have a serious discussion on serious topics related to pop culture and gaming. While I wanted to, except the people who want to have serious discussions about these serious topics are taking these issues in the most non-serious way possible. For example, when Waypoint made that article about how we at Waypoint would never forget how you treated LGBT people, Atlas, Waypoint brought up serious issues about LGBT people, but then proceed to misrepresent Naoto from Persona 4. I can't honestly talk about LGBT issues when you misrepresent one of the most beloved characters in the series. It's not Atlas who mishandled Naoto, it's you who mishandled her portrayal in this article. I want you to see how difficult it is to have an honest discussion about these issues with these people. It's almost like these people don't even care at all. It's almost like they don't actually want to solve these problems. They instead want to keep dodging the issues while somehow finding ways to benefit from all of that. But in doing so, they will demean those who actually have these serious problems and trivializing them into a bunch of petty nonsense. Which brings us to bully hunters. Bully hunters are a bunch of people who will hunt bullies on the internet who harass women in games. Not players, mind you, women. They want to have a discussion about online harassment. Not an honest one, but a discussion nonetheless. So I will gladly give them the courtesy to do so. In this video, I will try not to mock them as many others do, but I want you to know that the moment you witness this entire thing unfolding before your very eyes, I wouldn't blame you if you would resort in nothing but mockery. So Bully Hunters has a couple of videos on their YouTube channel. The videos just show clips of people mocking each other on CSGO in the most vulgar manner that you can think of, telling them to go to the freaking kitchen, telling them that they're gonna rape their dead bodies, many other things. To the blind untrained eye, that seems to be a terrible environment to be in. That is until you realize that the mute button is available for anyone to use to shut these people off. Now obviously there are responses to the use the mute button argument, and it seems to be along the lines of, well, muting is just you running away from the problem. How about we try to find ways to fix the culture and behaviors? In that way we can benefit from a healthy environment. Well, the problem is, you're playing video games competitively. Vulgar banters between competitors are very common in pretty much every competition ever. Is it terrible? Yes, in a lot of ways it is supposed to be terrible. They are trying to drop your confidence and lower your morality, a tactic that, as evidenced by your videos and your entire stream, works so well that you decided to tell people to stop doing it. Or more accurately, jump into people's games and just straight up kill the person and leave a freaking calling card like they're the Phantom Thieves or something. Now when you're talking about doxing, stalking, or downright criminal behaviors on the internet, then obviously that should be condemned. But you are conflating those with what you are showing on the screen here, which is people shouting at each other on the internet with vulgar words. This will happen if you are playing competitively against each other. This will happen on the internet in general, actually. If you're playing a co-op game, this probably wouldn't happen because you are allies instead of enemies. Okay, mostly it doesn't happen. We human beings are very competitive creatures. We strive to become better. We struggle to be the best. Well, most people struggle to be the best. But the point is, our competitive nature that is built under our DNA can result in some unwarranted hostilities. If you have ever been into any sort of competition before, you will feel hostility towards each other. You will feel the need to win. You will strive to be the best of all. I don't know how else am I going to explain you this, but what happened in there in CSGO is very hostile and unwarranted, but it's impossible to fix. We are competitive. Competition invites hostilities. To think that you can fix the toxic environment of competition is unbelievably naive. It is a very utopian and childish mindset. Wouldn't it be good for everyone to just be nice, love each other, and just hug it out? That's not gonna happen. Like, at all. Sorry, but that's just the reality of the situation. Moving on from the utterly inane premise, Bully Hunters decided to show us statistics and facts. For example, how 21 million female gamers have reported sexual harassment in-game. The citation for this is an article from VG247 from a poll of 874 people. I don't know about you, but that's not a very representative sample, so this is not even accurate.
If you think harassment is just part of the game, we know who you are. We know what you play. And we are coming for you.
Is this the part where I'm supposed to be intimidated?
No, seriously, am I supposed to be intimidated by that? If you think that harassment is not part of the game, then please explain to me what your ideal utopian gaming environment would be. Please elaborate how this can be in some ways practical to the real world. And most importantly, please explain to me how are you going to school those Call of Duty children? There are millions of them and you don't really know if you're going to meet one or you're going to meet a grown adult. So, Bully Hunters, please explain to me why are you doing this? What kind of benefit that you will gain from this? Well, besides the sponsorships, obviously.
We are a collective of gamers, brands, and organizations.
Okay, stop. Is that supposed to be a distorted voice? Because I can clearly hear your original voice there. All you did there was to have the original voice at the top of a low-pitch voice. I can still hear the original.
This is how you do a distorted voice. You distort it to the point where your original voice is almost indistinguishable.
I acknowledge that this is a petty nitpick that distracts from the main point, but if you are trying to be anonymous, you've done a really bad job at it.
Fighting to eliminate in-game harassment. By introducing a global tool that connects victims with skilled gamers in real time.
And does this work in every game? You've only shown in CSGO so far, so those Overwatch players are gonna have to wait, I guess. Also, I want to point out that comments and ratings are disabled for pretty much all of their videos on their channel, so yeah. This show is a failure from day one, and it shows. Do I have to show you the clips where they absolutely fail? Well, I'm going to show you one example. So we have this clip over here of a lady being put under the spotlight. This lady is the victim of the supposed harassment. Now, if you zoom in right there, for all of you CSGO players, it looks like she's playing in Safe House, but then subsequently the host goes into her feed and it shows an entirely different map, which is Cobblestone. Now, if this is pre-recorded, I probably wouldn't have that much of an issue, but they don't disclose it, and they're making you to think that this is a live feed when it clearly isn't. So the technical details are messed up, and it doesn't stop just on the actual show. The Twitch chat is populated by people spamming Uganda Knuckles, and they're doing it just to show how ridiculous these people are. A show that is supposed to be an hour is only 30 minutes. The backlash that comes towards this show has perhaps made these people to stop doing it at all. It's evidently not real, as you can see through this clip alone. But the most egregious part out of this entire debacle is the aftermath, because that's when people find out that this entire thing is fake, as if the trailers didn't convince you enough already. So the host herself confirms it by showing the freaking screenplay. Not only that, but the footage that you saw last time, even the host admitted that it was staged. Right after denying that it was staged. The host decided to take a break from this entire thing, and she did interviews with Kotaku, Polygon, and many other certainly reputable game websites that definitely looked at the stream and thought, wow, this is the dumbest thing that I have ever seen in a while. You want more evidence that this entire thing is staged? The users who are being bullied are the same person as the Bully Hunters. The Bully Hunters are literally played by the same account for some reason. Rather than being a stream about serious discussions of online harassment, this is just a stupid attempt at viral marketing. You people are only using harassment as an excuse to sell headsets. Now please tell me, am I a bad person for mocking people who trivializes serious issues to this ridiculous degree? Am I the person trivializing serious issues in this room? I am trying to take this seriously. You guys don't. So can somebody please appoint me someone who will? In the stream, it's very much evident that they're just there to sell SteelSeries headsets. One of the hosts of this entire stream is doing nothing but shilling the stream. When somebody asked for source of the harassment studies and who did it, she asked her to just watch watch the stream. I think this person down below has illustrated the point very well. It's pretty much false advertising. It turns out that this entire thing is organized by an agency called FCB Chicago, and some of the members are linked to venture capital firms. Now, if you're asking for more info on the harassment claims, whose link is put right next to a freaking SteelSeries headset, at best you are dismissed. At worst, you are called entitled. A mental health researcher gives her take on this entire thing, and at best she got dismissed by being told to watch the stream. At worst, the host calls her insulting. This is what I'm referring to in the beginning. If you want to talk about serious issues like online harassment, great, but if you're doing it in a manner that is awfully dishonest and demeans an opposing viewpoint merely because they're asking for data, then we're not gonna get anywhere with this. I will perhaps continue to resort in mockery because you didn't take this issue as seriously as you claim. Now, while SteelSeries is shilling this relentlessly, it turns out that in a Bully Hunter's channel, apparently there was a video from SteelSeries shilling their headset, but the video was removed. Now that is quite odd indeed. One of their clinical experts turns out to be a helper in diabetes? What? And to conclude this entire debacle, they put this rather insane rant repeating their false narratives by calling the people who attacked them right-wing trolls. And no, let's add that finishing trademark touch on that SteelSeries name there. So let me ask you something. If you're one of those people who criticizes me for trivializing serious issues by mocking people who bring it up, can you honestly tell me that I'm doing exactly that here? It's not me who trivializes these issues, it's them. I tried to take this seriously. People tried to take this seriously. People tried to bring in just an inch of skepticism throughout this entire thing, but their attempt is met with contempt and ridicule. Do you want to know why we can't have serious discussions about serious topics like this? Well, Bully Hunters proved it. It's a terrible show attempting to solve the problem of online harassment in the most ridiculous possible manner by faking, lying, manipulating, and being generally unpleasant to anyone who dares to bring some form of skepticism to their claims. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention that the host herself has said really mean words too towards others, both on Twitter and in-game.
Such faggots. I don't know what to do. It makes me not want to play. We want to play Battlefield? We want to play something else? Because these faggots are just going to chase me around.
And the excuse is that the clip was edited? It was in good sport with her BF? Ex-BF? She's bi? It was 5 years ago? Like, these are chains of excuses after excuses. Pick one, please. So yes, maybe Bully Hunters are bringing up serious issues about online harassment. Maybe they are trying to solve the problem, even if the solution is ridiculous. Hey, it's much better to have a solution rather than none whatsoever, right? I want to have a discussion about solving the issues of internet privacy, and my proposal to that is to obviously nuke Facebook. Oh, by the way, very quick last minute update. It turns out that SteelSeries, Cyberpower PC, and Vertigear, the brands who are involved in sponsoring this event, they completely disavow Bully Hunters. According to an investigation by Richard Lewis, SteelSeries was simply approached by a marketing campaign, FCB Chicago, and agreed to be part of an event. The campaign is so damaging to their brand, and they believe that the marketers misrepresented the level of SteelSeries' involvement. All of these companies have made statements regarding this massive epic failure. You can read the statements right here. Here's from SteelSeries, here's from Cyberpower PC, and here's from Vertigear. So it turns out that this isn't a viral marketing campaign hiding under the guise of harassment merely to sell headsets. It's actually more diabolical. These companies are scammed by a marketing campaign to push false agendas while finding ways to profit from it by sponsorships from gaming companies. They trick these gaming companies into thinking that they're contributing into some sort of a noble cause, but well, it's clearly not. So yep, Bully Hunters is a scam in many different levels, and SteelSeries and many other companies have become victims of them. Maybe you should do some investigations before jumping in the bandwagon, SteelSeries. I hope you and many other companies can take notes from this epic failure of an event.